Tammy Stewart here at Help for a Purpose. I hope you've watched some of our previous Facebook posts, because we're going to build on that just a little bit today. If you haven't watched them, go back and watch those, because it'll build a better foundation, so everything we say today is going to make more sense. How many of you know the hormone age faster than any other hormone? I'm going to give you a second to think about that. Post below. Let me know if you know what it is. Like our post also and share it with your friends, because you have friends who would be very interested in this, I know. I'll give you the answer to the question first. Insulin. Insulin will make you age faster than any other hormone. So let's think about how we can keep our insulin as low as possible so that we look younger longer. Isn't everyone interested in that? Looking and feeling younger longer, right? So, going back to our previous classes, this is your cell, two layers of fat on the outside of the cell. And hopefully you're drawing this yourself, because then you'll learn it differently. It'll put it in a different place in your brain when you're actually drawing it. These are your hormone receptors on the outside of the cell. It carries the message to the cell. When your cell is inflamed, your hormone receptors can't work. So let's say that this is your insulin receptor and it's all burned out, kind of like your ears are all plugged up and you can't hear people speaking. Or like you're at a club or a dinner and there's a live band and you can't hear the people next to you. I never have understood why we do that. Because don't you go to be with your friends, but yet you can't hear because of the music? So anyway, so that insulin receptor is burned out. So then what do you think happens to the insulin that your body's creating? If it can't get into the cell, then it's just sitting there making you look older and feel older. So two solutions to the problem. Number one, let's keep our insulin as low as possible. Number two, when the body does create insulin, let's get it into the cell so that it's not just sitting there making you look older. So, the solution to the inflammation problem, you should remember from our previous post, three things cause inflammation: sugars and grains, bad fats, and toxins. Let's think about one other thing, though. In our previous post, we've talked about what you can do to keep you from getting hungry, become a fat burner, and then you can eat less often. You can eat like maybe during a 5 or 6 hour window. And here's another reason that you want to do that. Let's say that this is your insulin when you wake up in the morning. And you eat food and your insulin goes up. If you go by the current popular theory of you should eat every couple of hours. So your insulin goes up and a couple of hours later it has gone down a little bit. But you eat again and it goes down a little, and then you eat again and then it goes down, and then you eat. You see my point. If you eat every 2 hours, your insulin by the end of the day is crazy high. On the other hand, let's say that this is your beginning insulin, and you eat at 1 o'clock, and your insulin goes up, and it comes all the way back down. It takes maybe a few hours to do that. So then maybe at 5 o'clock you eat again, and your insulin goes up, and it comes all the way back down. You get the point? Your insulin is lower overall all day every day because you're eating less often and you're waiting about 4 hours in between your meals. And you want to get rid of that inflammation so that insulin goes in the cell, because if you have cellular inflammation, even this insulin can't get into the cell effectively. So that even this situation is going to age you more often. So I hope that that is something that you did not know. I hope you learned something so that you feel like you got a good investment from your, a good return on your investment of time this evening. Like the post, comment, share it with your friends.